Mallala last hosted a round of the Australian Touring Car Championship 18 years ago. On that occasion, Bob Jayne won. In those days, of course, it was the General versus Ford. It's little the same way today, but the Fords we see in the pursuit of the Park Royal Pole are a little different.
The 2.6K Mallala Park circuit might not possess the same character of a Sandown or Oran Park, but it can claim all the right ingredients for one tight and tough Turo title shootout. The track is noticeably narrow, has more lumps and bumps than a motocross layout, and is extremely unforgiving. Most drivers like it, but Dick Johnson isn't one of them.
We're trying to put an act together, which is trying to be a very highly polished act, and we have to come to a venue which I don't think really fits the bill.
I think that every circuit we go to is different, and I mean this one, just because everyone hasn't been here, they're bagging it. I mean, to me, it's a great little track. It's got some fast corners, it's got some slow corners. Every circuit in Australia has got bumps here and there, so we shouldn't complain about bumps, but I think it's terrific. I mean, it's brought a lot of the series back closer to the cars that, you know, don't have a chance on a long, fast track, which is great for the sport.
I think it's a great race track. You can be very aggressive here and give the car heaps, and I've enjoyed it so far.
The battle for the Park Royal Pole started with Friday's expression session, and George Fury was one of the first to take a ride on the wild side when he looped the Nissan. Tony Longhurst and Peter Brock were testing the limits of adhesion in their Sierras, while an out-of-sorts Dick Johnson missed most of the action due to nature calling at 30-second intervals. Saturday dawned overcast and cool, and Johnson responded from the outset with a stunning lap of 1 minute 10.62 seconds, a remarkable 8-tenths of a second faster than any other driver.
Well, I made it a point where I didn't go before I went out, and I had to get back in a hurry.
Mallala is a neat piece of blacktop for the more experienced hands of the game. And Johnson aside, there was not a better combination yesterday than Colin Bond and the Caltex CXT Cosworth Sierra. Bondi bounded over the bumps to stop the clocks at 1 minute 11.40 seconds, second fastest time, and a share of the front row.
Well, it's a little bit more like a rally circuit, I think, than a racetrack. We have done a few laps around here before in the Alpha, and I think it's an interesting circuit. It'd be fantastic in the wet because the corners are relatively slow, and I think the cars, with the amount of horsepower we've got, all scrabbling trying to get, you know, horsepower to the ground coming out of corners. It'd be very, very interesting, and it's a very safe circuit, of course.
Not so lucky was Wanneroo round winner John Bowe, second fastest in unofficial practice on Friday, but only eighth quickest yesterday when the pressure was on.
Well, in the first time session, the car dropped its fuel pressure, which means nothing to me, but it wouldn't go. It didn't have any power. So I drove my backside off and ended up eighth on the grid.
Holden's promised factory assault on this year's championship is yet to materialise. But in the meantime, West Australians Tim Slato and Alf Barbagallo are keeping the General in touch with consumers. The Sandgropers will start well down the grid today, but at least they'll bring a much-needed V8 roar to proceedings.
We're quite proud of them. The whole team has put a lot of effort into this. When I say the whole team, Alf, all the boys, the 10 boys are working it, and we took great care in building them, and we're pretty pleased with them. Turned out well.
Yeah, it is different. Yeah, with Speedway, you're sort of there driving all the time. Here you've got time to think and do deals.
Rain put pay to the afternoon session yesterday, so the morning time stood unchallenged, with pole position to Dick Johnson, Colin Bond alongside in the Caltex Sierra. Row 2, the Sierras of Peter Brock and Tony Longhurst. Row 3, the impressive Nissan Skylines of Jim Richards and George Fury, with Mark Skaife right behind them in the third of the GTS-R turbos. John Bowe starts from position 8 in the second of the Shell cars. From 9, Alan Moffat in the ANZ Sierra, while Brad Jones rounds off the top 10.
Anywhere where it's not raining, I'd be wrapped, because every meeting we've been to this year, it's been raining. But at least, you know, with the Park Royal Prize, it really gives you something to shoot for in pole, and that's probably one of the reasons why I try so hard.
Dickie Johnson, Park Royal pole sitter for the fifth round of the Australian Touring Car Championship this afternoon at Mallala. We have the cars on the grid. We're going to take a break and then return for round 5, Thunder and Lightning from South Australia. And welcome back to Mallala Raceway. 60 k's away from Adelaide for round 5 of the Australian Touring Car Championship. Dick Johnson, as you know, has pole position for today's race. Colin Bond sharing the front row. Next out of three is Peter Brock, then Tony Longhurst, Richards and Fury, Mark Skaife, a marvellous debut in the third of the Nissan GTS-R turbos, John Bowe, unaccustomed to position 8 in the field. He's usually on the front row. Alan Moffat's in there in the ANZ car. Brad Jones, Tim Slaker, Chris Lambden in the Bow Repairs Holden. Alf Barbagallo, Gerald Kay, Joe Somariva, John Faulkner, Jeff Full, Darrell Bennett, Neville Crichton, David Sala and Bob Holder at the tail of the field. And I guess the big question here today is going to be whether anyone else can out-accelerate Dick Johnson off the line. Johnson was 8 tenths quicker than anyone yesterday. He has two gun-ho guys behind him in Peter Brock, who's running strongly this season, and of course Tony Longhurst in the Benson and Hedges Sierra. And we'll keep an eye on the two Nissans today too, or the three. Jimmy Richards, of course, George Fury and Mark Skaife. Getting ready for the start. There's Colin Bond driving for Caltex in the CXT Sierra. 10 seconds away from the start. Round 5 from Mallala. Racing, Colin Bond and Dick Johnson side by side off the line. And it might be Bond, but Johnson will pick up the pace down on the inside as they go to the first corner. Almost a touch of guards there as they all try and get into the first turn. There's one off sideways.
It's one of the mobile cars. Whoa, and it's Brock who's all out of shape and he's gone round. He's got Fury at his door. Oh, and Brad Jones, thank you very much. There's John Bow as well. Oh, for a paddle beater.
Well, that's, I guess, was always going to happen. We didn't know where in the field. But let's have a look as they work their way now onto the short straight. Dick Johnson at 17 now leads from Colin Bond and the Caltex Sierra. Right behind him, Tony Longhurst keeping the pressure on. And it looks like young Tony wants to get up and run with Johnson at the head of the pack and makes his move down the outside. There's some late braking here. Bond's got the inside. No, that was never going to work.
Longhurst in the mud. Locks up the fronts on the way now. He's going to be lucky to get out of there. It's pretty damn wet.
He'll get back, but he's just blown what he had working for him.
Dropped two positions there, Tony Longhurst. Why, gee, look at that Commodore. It's up close.
Yes, that was Tim Slaker going through in the Commodore.
The order, Johnson, then Bond, then Richards, a good start, followed by Alan Moffat, followed by a recovering Tony Longhurst, Tim Slaker, Chris Lambden, John Bow with the rear hanging off his car, Gerald Kay, Neville Crichton, Peter Brock, Jim Richards, Brad Jones.
There's Tim Slaker coming through leading the Commodore charge. Chris Lambden right behind him in the Bow Repairs entry and John Bow coming back through the pack.
Oh, I stand corrected. That's Mark Skaife, not Jim Richards. So Mark's done a great job. A good clean start and he's got the boss, Alan Moffat, right on his tail at the moment.
It's been an eventful first lap at Mallala.
Certainly has. Alan Moffat in the ANZ Sierra sitting right behind Mark Skaife. But up front, it's Dick Johnson in car number 17. Stretching it over Colin Bond. It's the next group to go through.
Skaife under pressure from Moffat. Crichton just behind them. Moffat out wide under brakes. He's going to do a Tony Longhurst if he's not careful. No, he's got a wiser and older head on his shoulders.
There's Longhurst coming back through yet again. He was really in a challenging position, but overcooked it. This time Longhurst comes down on the inside. So if anyone's going to make a move out into the kiddie litter, it'll be Alan Moffat. He does it. Longhurst manages to sneak through there.
One thing you don't see Alan do very often is spear off or make mistakes that cost him money. He's running on a tight but effective budget, and he's in it to finish. Tony Longhurst is on the assault at the moment, chasing Mark Skaife, making his Shell Ultra Australian Touring Car Championship debut for 89. He drove with Nissan last year, made a couple of appearances in the Touring Car Championship and of course did very well in some of the long distance races. And he's got Tony Longhurst, the Tui's 1000 winner, hammering away at the back at the moment. And the difficulty that all these guys face at the moment is, as we've mentioned a few times, the track is a little slick, a lot of gravel on it, lots of oil being deposited from some of the earlier races, and these guys are fighting grip problems.
There goes Longhurst.
He coasted down on the inside of Mark Skaife. Alan Moffat sits back in the ANZ car as they work their way down the back straight. And look at John Bow starting to gather them in. We'll get a tail shot shortly of John Bow's car, and you'll notice all the coachwork's just about hanging off there.
Dick Johnson opening up the gap that's about a Mallala mile
in local terms.
Well, it's certainly a country mile out here.
Yes, he's got this one wrapped up even now. Well clear, running away, doing it easily, and about half a straight already on Colin Bond in the Caltex Sierra. But this is where the action is in the pack. Tony Longhurst, 25, Mark Skaife in 12, Moffat in 9, followed by John Bow, then a fair gap, then back to Peter Brock. Oh, and here comes John Bow into the pits. And this is a very, very narrow pit road, let me tell you.
He was black flagged, so that'll really have John's pulse starting to quicken, and there's a lot of rubbish there. I don't know how dangerous it is, but I suppose it looks a bit ungainly. You don't want that laying around on the track, so bow to the pits. How long will it take them to rip all this garbage off the back?
He's the championship leader, remember?
He's had one of those weekends, now he's away. Not bad, just over 15 seconds.
So Bow rejoins the fray as we pick up on Longhurst, Skaife and Moffat, continuing their scrap for third place in the pack.
If you're wondering where Jim Richards is and Peter Brock, they were caught up in a tangle at the first turn. They're a little bit back in the pack at the moment, as was, of course, John Bow. A lot of smoke down the back straight there. Somebody under brakes in the corner, sending up a big cloud. Longhurst in pursuit of Colin Bond and closing ground on the second place getter rapidly. Dick Johnson leads. Bond second, Longhurst third.
One of the Commodores depositing plenty of oil on the road at the moment.
Yeah, Tim Slako.
That's a worry because there's plenty of slippery stuff out there as it is. Okay, there's Moffat in the ANZ car.
He's battling along, Alan Moffat in the number 9 car.
Not far astern of Alan Moffat, we've got some of those drivers we were talking about. There's Slako.
Is that the right rear guard?
Right, yes, yeah, rubber.
It's not engine oil, thank goodness.
Fortunately, he's had a touch and has had to come in for a wheel change and to try and pull some of the bodywork away.
The Barbagello team are very well presented, you know, they've done a great job.
He's got a bit of work to do there because that's wedged fairly solidly on the tyre after a touch with another car. So they're working him on.
Talking about well presented, there's 05 Peter Brock, and he's won the Best Presented Car Award from Dulux Auto Colour 4 this meeting. Unfortunately, he was in that dust up at the first corner that's put him back in the field a little bit, but he's got a real race on his hands there. That's John Bow on his tail. Neville Crichton tucked in behind as well, and Jim Richards not far away. Chris Lambden leads the Commodores. We go in car with Sevens race cam with Peter Brock.
Brock now running 11th on the road. Busier than a one-armed paper hanger in a gale. And having a little pass put on him there by John Bow, who wants to get on with it and get back on the same lap.
Mike, just looking at Brock's car, it's got all sorts of biffs and barges in it, so I've got a fair old indication here that the geometry of the car is going to be all over the shop. But then so too John Bow. You can just see by the way the car's reacting in the cockpit that it's not too pleasant to drive at the moment. Watch it coming out of here as he feeds on 500 odd horsepower, gets power to the ground pretty smoothly, and he's having a little chat on the radio to crew chief Alan Gow at the moment.
Tony Longhurst will be up to keep on his tail, given another half lap. Neville Crichton also in the second of the Benson and Hedges cars coming down the back straight, so it hasn't been a good start this race for Peter Brock.
As the leader, Dick Johnson, high-balling along in front. How important was it to be the quick qualifier? Oh, goodness me.
Colin Bond, in fact, had a half lose coming out of the corner and has gone for a spin off on the grass, and that's dropped him down a spot or two from second back to about fifth. So it's all happening. The only one who hasn't put a foot wrong here today is Dick Johnson in the number 17 Sierra. Bondi gets off and starts running again as Johnson goes through.
How important is that pole position on a track like this? Johnson clear of all the trouble.
Peter Brock to the pits. He was behind teammate Brad Jones, and remember they had it coming together in turn two. Side of the cars knocked around pretty substantially. It's all good news for Dick Johnson at the moment.
Johnson leading now from Tony Longhurst. Mark Skaife is running third. What a bonus for him. In the third of the Nissan Skyline entries. The leading lights for Nissan, Jim Richards and George Fury, a little further back in the pack. They're involved in the scrap of fourth, fifth, sixth positions.
Well, they all paid the penalty in the opening lap, and Mark was able to sort of thread his way through, and it's all been a bonus.
Good crowd here at the Mallala circuit, 60 kilometres north of Adelaide.
Take our Dulux Auto Colour race cam. We're riding with Jimmy Richards as he sits on the tail of Colin Bond. Bond was running in second, but that spin has cost him dearly. He's back into the pack and had fallen back into the hands of Jimmy Richards. Got away again for a spell, and Richards closes up under brakes. We've got Alf Barbagallo and the Asanda Commodore just ahead of them. So some great pictures coming to you from Dulux Auto Colour Race Cam in Jim Richards' car.
Fifth round of the Australian Touring Car Championship from Mallala in South Australia. This is the scrap for fourth, fifth and sixth positions between Alan Moffat, Colin Bond, Jim Richards. Dick Johnson continues to lead the race by 10 seconds to Tony Longhurst, a further 6 seconds to Mark Skaife in third place, and 6 seconds more back to this group, Alan Moffat, Bond, Richards. John Bauer not far away from them either.
Bond poking the nose of the Caltech Sierra up on the inside of Moffat then. There's no way he was going ahead with it. Jimmy Richards sitting right in behind them. We've got this well covered for you with our race cam, our Dulux Auto Colour race cam, sitting right in behind. As you can see, certain parts of the racetrack, Colin Bond will have a real lunge at Alan Moffat. Richards goes in for the ride. They run up on a lap car, then they open up again. Some great picks here today from Mallala. Gives you also an idea of just how tight this racetrack is, and certainly how bumpy it is. The person who should know how bumpy it is, don't go to sleep there, Neil Crompton.
I'm still recovering. I'm trying to put all the fillings back in their places. This is an exciting dice, isn't it? You've got three of the very best drivers in three perfectly turned out machines. Two former teammates in Colin Bond and Alan Moffat. Bondy, oh, he skates in. Gets away with that only just. Bit of rally experience showing through there. The former Aussie rally champ hanging onto it by the skin of its teeth. And Jim ready to pounce in case Alan makes the slightest mistake or leaves half a gap.
He's going to try and get down the inside under brakes here if he can.
He does.
Oops.
Oh, and locks one up on the way in. That didn't help.
See, Jim's got plenty of pressure from John Bauer as well. I noticed that it was the left rear on Richard's car that locked up that time. So he's got to go and do all that hard work again now. That's the gap. And it's unbelievable when you... Oh,
yeah, that was a good one.
It was a good one. It's unbelievable when you're trying to tag another bloke. It's like you're on the end of an elastic band and you just pray that he comes back towards you. But it never, ever happens. You just have to keep working at it.
Johnson still leading that big gap over Tony Longhurst. Mark Skaife.
You know, one thing that I think has to be said, Mike, is that this type of track, and there's a tremendous shot. Caltech's race cam looking backwards at John Bauer from the boot lid of Jim Richards' Nissan.
Yes, where they go to put the key in and open the trunk, that's where we've got one of our new mini cameras, our Caltech mini cam. This will give you an idea of out the back of Jim Richards' car. John Bauer has made up a lot of ground on him. That's his riding as close as you can to the ground as Bauer makes a move down the inside. Leads on Jimbo and gets through. That was a good move.
The point that I was going to make, Mike, is we come to a different circuit where nobody has any prior data settings on suspension and things like that. And all of a sudden, it's like tossing all the marbles up and seeing what comes down. We've got guys spearing off, all sorts of different dices going on. It just provides a bit of inconsistency, breaks the thing out of its rhythm, which has turned out to be quite entertaining.
It hasn't broken Dick Johnson's rhythm.
No. Can anybody? Even the dreaded Lurgy didn't.
Yeah, well, Johnson's 10 seconds still over Tony Longhurst in the lead. Further 10 seconds to Mark Skaife in third place, and then 5 seconds to this great dice we've got going on here for fourth, fifth, sixth and seventh positions involving Alan Moffat, Colin Bond, Jim Richards and John Bauer. Chris Lambden heads the Commodore Brigade, fairly well back in the pack at this stage from Gerald Kay. And Alf Barbagallo. Slako, of course, lost time when he had to go to the pits for a wheel change.
Neil said they threw all the marbles up in the first corner. And I tell you what, seeing the positions have settled down fairly well now, it might be timely to just recap the start of this race with the view that we had from our Caltex race cam out the back of Jim Richards' Nissan Skyline. This is what it looked like as they headed down to the first corner. Moffat making a run down there on the inside. There's Brock, I believe, who missed completely.
There's Young Skaife, George Fury. Oh.
Jim's gone at this stage.
John Bauer, you just saw as well, tail out.
Well, it was all the big squeeze, wasn't it?
Certainly was. And that's what happened, in fact, in the first corner.
It was a different view of the action.
It was like trying to put the square peg in the round hole. There were three cars and only room for two. And my old boss got the short back and sides on that one.
Yep.
He's been in pretty good form this weekend too. He qualified very effectively and he'll be pretty disappointed with where he's ended up in this one. But he's working back through the pack.
Start finishing line, Gerald Kay just had a spin there, you can see. Drops the clutch and heads down again. That is a very tricky corner down through the S's. Already had Bond go off there and have a lose. And just trying to get back Flory's way through the traffic again.
Another Sierra having a bit of a smoke and a smolder out there as well. There's a few cars not looking too good.
This is the scrap of the race so far. We're following it for you. Colin Bond in the Caltex Sierra. Alan Moffat in the ANZ machine. And the second of the Dick Johnson cars with John Bauer at the wheel. Then Jim Richards behind him.
And they're all closing up pretty quickly now on Mark Skaife.
Well, I believe Skaife so far has turned into the driver of the race.
He has. He's putting on a great show.
One second.
I know he puts a lot of emphasis on fitness, and so it'll be interesting to see how physically and mentally fit it is. These guys have been hammering away at it for a long time. There goes John Bauer.
Now making a run on the outside of Alan Moffat's ANZ Sierra. Bauer moves up on the tail of Bond. Richard stays in there. So Bauer, who's already down a bit after losing out the first turn. Bondi charges through there and works on his way down the back straight.
Ooh.
Yeah, he wanted to be on the inside coming down here. There was no way he wanted to do the outside routine.
Bondi said, if you want to go down the inside, that's fine, John, but I'll leave you about 2.5 centimetres. Now Bow on the outside. Now, this puts him in a great position when he gets to the hairpin right-hander. And John Bow just squeezes by now and makes another move. It's an effective one. Jumps up a slot.
Puts him up to fourth spot.
That was a good move.
He's a tremendous stinker in a motor car. There's the shot from Dulux Auto Colour Race Cam. Jim Richards at the helm, three Sierras in front. And notice that this track has also mixed the brands up a little bit more. The Nissan is a little bit closer now to the Sierra than it's been in previous weekends. And Alan really doing plenty of defending.
Yep.
And I don't reckon there's a worse bloke in the world to have breathing down your neck than Jim Richards. He's a tenacious driver.
Race order still Dick Johnson, leader from Tony Longhurst, Mark Skaife from the Nissan, then John Bauer, Bond, Moffat, Richards, Fury and Brad Jones. Dickie boys, crew just standing by in case. I don't think we'll have rain today. And I wouldn't imagine he's having excessive tyre wear out there.
Well, they'll have done their homework on choosing their compounds, and Dunlop have got a variety of them available for the car. And the only thing they'll be worried about is if he happens to have a rub and puts a guard on a tyre. So all the threat of showers has certainly evaporated. Now we've got...
Back to the Dulux race cam.
Wasn't that silly? It was awfully wet and cold this morning.
It certainly was. Well, Moffat gets away with the pressure off him just for the moment. Bauer gets away, and here comes Richards down on the inside of Colin Bond. They're pacing it out. Oh, almost drilled him in the door. But being the gentleman he is, Jim keeps the pressure on, so Bondy is doing this one fairly tough.
Jim will be programmed for gap at the moment.
Yes.
The minute he sees one, he'll drive into it. I don't know about this gentleman caper.
I think Jim is actually looking forward to a wet race.
I tell you what, it's doing well at the moment. It's putting its power to the ground and he's now in a good strong position. He outplaces Colin Bond for the kink in the back straight. And I doubt whether Bond will be able to respond under brakes. Great shots again from Dulux Auto Colour Race Cam. And now It's the Nissan-to-Nissan confrontation with, oh, George Fury sneaking through as well. So Fury gets away, having already been in the pits. And they stretch it out going down the back straight. They've had one of the little Toyotas run off the course down there.
There it is.
There it is. It's our Caltech's race cam out the trunk of the Jim Richards machine. The George Fury and the other Nissan sitting back behind him. An idea of just how windy this circuit is at Mallala.
Get a bit of a shock when you put the shopping in the back of it, wouldn't you, with all the cameras and cables and things in there?
Yeah, the race cam boys have done exceptionally well.
Well, it gives us another dimension. And it's interesting to look at the shot and just see one of the pink Commodores off there, the Asanda entries. It's interesting to see how much the rear of the car swishes around. And you start to get an idea then of the stresses and strains involved in this type of racing on these cars.
Back at Mallala Raceway, race leader Dick Johnson, car number 17, the Shell Sierra, coming down the back straight. And boy, has he opened a gap over the rest of the field here today. He's in a class of his own.
10 seconds, the break on Tony Longhurst.
Longhurst has tried to hold on to Johnson, but you'll be able to see the gap as Johnson heads down the start finishing straight. No sign of Tony Longhurst, but there he is there. Of course, in the Benson and Hedges Sierra.
Johnson has just lapped that car going out of shot, Chris Lambden's Commodore. So there are only 11 cars on the front running lap.
Tony could be headed for another second place finish here today after last weekend's round at Wataru Park. Tony, of course, started the season as Tui's 1000 winner. Winner of the great race on the mountain last year. He's fifth in the 88 Australian Touring Car Championship and fourth in the current one with 28.5 points. 31 years of age and comes from the Gold Coast. And there's Colin Bond in the Caltech Sierra in the pits. Problems for Colin.
The race is run.
Now that is bad luck because Colin did a tremendous job in qualifying. A front row performance. And I know he's put a lot of effort in. His crew have worked very hard. And well, you can see where the problem is.
Michael Brown there from Caltex, who travels to the touring car rounds. You're right, they were looking good. A slice of the front row after yesterday's qualifying. Changed engines overnight, ran a motor in early this morning at about 6:30 here at the circuit. But there's the man still sitting in second spot, Tony Longhurst, in car number 25, the Benson and Hedges Sierra.
He's about 11 seconds behind Johnson now. John Bowers in third spot. The gap from Longhurst back to Bowers, 16 seconds. Mark Skaife still fourth, but Jim Richards closing rapidly on him. It's Richards with our Dulux autocolor race cam, and Mark Skaife up in front of him, about to fall into his clutches. This is the battle for fourth position.
Well, one thing I've wanted to do for a long, long time was make a little call to my old friend Richo in this thing, but he's very, very busy at the moment. But we've never spoken to Jim on Racecam before. It's something to look forward to perhaps later today or later in the season. But one way or the other, over the years, we've never really seen too much Racecam activity from Jim. We saw a little bit of it last year in the Mobile BMW N3 at Bathurst, but he is a picture to watch. Unflustered, very smooth, doesn't make too many mistakes. And Mark Skaife at the moment bearing the brunt of the Richards attack.
At least two are only 3.5 seconds behind John Bowers. So if Richards can get away past Skaife here, I think John Bowers' position in third spot won't be too safe.
Well, I think the way the Bowers come back through the field, it's unlikely anyone's going to touch him. 15 second stop in the pits to pull the bodywork off the back of the car.
Oh, well, Moffat's gone round.
Moffat in car number 9, the ANZ Sierra. on the left turn to the pits, past the pits I should say. Now Richards moving right in behind young Mark Skaife. Leaves plenty of room, Jim goes through. Noisy gearbox in the Nissan, clunk, clunk, clunk. Always been that way. They sound good though, don't they? There's the shot from Caltex race cam. Key cam. It's certainly a different view. Shows you how the cars actually move around on the circuit. That's Mark Skaife. Jim has just passed.
Alan Moffat lost one spot in that spin. George Fury is now ahead of him.
I'm a bit lost now. Garry, you might run through those all for me.
Yep, Johnson leading, Longhurst second, Bauer third, followed by Richards, then Mark Skaife, George Fury, Alan Moffat, Scratch, Colin Bond, of course. So the next car would be Brad Jones, followed by Neville Crichton and Peter Brock.
Not a bad performance from Brad Jones to be moving up through the field as well after coming in from 10th on the grid. Be interesting now to see what happens with 32 minutes down in this race. How tyre wear is going to affect it. It's a very busy little circuit, rocking the car pretty violently from side to side. And we'll see who's made the right judgment with the setup of their car and the tyres and compounds.
Peter Brock says his worry is not tyres, it's the rivets being shaken out of the car.
And the driver. It is tiring. John Bauer, always the charger. Former dual Australian driving champion of some open wheel fame. And overlooked, as I've mentioned a couple of times in commentary before, for many years in touring car racing, and then suddenly finally woke up to the fact he's a genius in a car.
Yep.
And Dick Johnson wasted no time in snatching this guy's ability. There he is from Devonport in Tassie. Said twice Australian driving champion. He was the second placed driver in last year's title, runner-up at the Tooheys 1000 in 88. That's twice he's been the runner-up there, and he's currently the leader in the series. And doesn't that put a smile on his face? John Bauer.
In terms of makes, we've got three Sierras up front, Johnson, Longhurst, Bauer, followed by three Nissans, Richard, Skaife and Fury, followed by four more Sierras, Moffat, Jones, Crichton, Brock, and then the first of the Commodores driven by Chris Lambden.
It's a good job from John considering he's been to the pits. Those who have just joined us, John Bauer was involved in a skirmish in the first turn along with about half the field. And you'll notice that the rear, plastic rear bumper work on the car has all been pulled away. He was black flagged, went to the pits, made about a 15 second stop, and he's charging back through the field again in third position. And Jeff Full just getting out of the way in the Toyota Corolla.
Wisely.
And John acknowledges his courtesy.
So Jimmy Richards still runs in fourth place. Mark Skaife is fifth. Alan Moffat sixth. Brad Jones seventh. Peter Brock is eighth. Neville Crichton ninth. Chris Lambden is tenth. And George Fury 11th after that pit stop.
I'd be very interested now to see whether or not John Bauer's closing on Tony Longhurst. There's certainly no doubt that Dick's unchallenged at the moment. It's very much a case of make a good start, make a good break, and then everything tends to stay the same. It's very frustrating for Tony because he probably thinks, well, gee, my car speed's okay, I'm driving at the right pace, but the brakes went against me at the beginning of the race and now I've got this buffer that I can't make up. This is the Burrapairs entry, the leading Commodore. Let's have a look at it on Dulux race cam. Chris Lambden, very successful supercar driver and formerly the editor of Auto Action, trade papers, supports motor racing. And Chris has devoted himself this year to racing well, pretty well professionally. He certainly turns himself out very professionally, even if it's not his 7 day a week occupation. And the Burrapairs team are well outfitted and they're doing probably the best they can with a car that is just lacking a little bit on this circuit. Now that's the car that Peter Brock drove to victory at Bathurst in 1987. It was the old car 10. It's been uprated to the current TWR spec fuel injected engine and with the bodywork on it. And that was a good old car, as I recall.
Yes. Could have won Bathurst, son.
Don't start.
if my uncle was Marty and all that story.
So Chris Lambden and the Bow Repairs Commodore heads off, still chasing Jimmy Richards. Richards' car disappears away as we pick up on our race leader, Dick Johnson, the Daisy Hill Demon, who has just been in sensational form, Hill at Mallala.
Welcome back to Mallala. Well, double trouble for the mobile team. Peter Brock's 05 car is in the pits and just been pushed behind the wall. And Brad Jones is also in the second of the mobile cars.
Yeah, very disappointing. And just rough guess, I'd say it's the same thing, whatever it is. They're looking around at the rear of the car. Car number 32. That's John Faulkner in the little front-wheel drive team Toyota Corolla. And
he's in the Guinness Book of Records, isn't he? Or at least they are. They keep winning this category, this class of racing all the time, the little Toyotas.
But they are just a great little engine, those 16-valve, four-cylinder jobs. They rev, rev, rev all day long. And Toyota have been bringing home the bacon for years in this class. And
I hope you're enjoying our telecast of the Australian Touring Car Championship, brought to you, in fact, by Toyota, by Caltex, and, of course, by ANZ Car Loans.
Talking about car loans, Toyota did that for us this weekend here at Mallala to enable us to get around. It is 60 k's out of Adelaide, a long way to travel, but travel smooth with the Toyota boys. Certainly John Faulkner travels smooth. One of the Sierras flying past there. Looks like Tony Longhurst in pursuit still of Dick Johnson at the head of affairs. And here we are on Dulux Autocolor race cam with Jim Richards.
And we might see whether or not we can create a bit of history. Jimmy Richards, can you hear us?
Sure can, Mike.
That's nice of you to volunteer to have a chat to us. How's it all going?
Well, it's going pretty good, but we're a little bit far back. But I can see Tony Long is slowing down a bit up here, so we keep trying hard. We might be able to catch him up, over.
Jim, it's Cromley here. What's the thing handling like at the moment?
It's handling pretty good. Someone's dumped a lot of oil around.
Wasn't me.
You went real good.
Yeah, thanks, mate. It was a bit of fun, wasn't it? Richo, a tyre's going to be a worry in this thing or not? Are they going to hang in there?
Well, they'll hang in there, but probably not that fast, unfortunately. I'm not going as fast as I'd like to, but about as fast as I can.
What was your version of what happened at the first turn?
Well, I don't know whether it was Brocky or who it was, but one of the mobile cars came through like it was no tomorrow's, and I just drove onto the grass so that he wouldn't T-bone me.
Well, thanks very much, Jim. Appreciate having a chat. I know you're busy and you want to make that gap up to your old teammate.
Thanks, buddy.
See ya.
Talking about making up gaps on old teammates, it's getting pretty desperate between Longhurst and Bauer. Oh, Longhurst in the pits.
Well, there goes second place, Tony Longhurst.
Well, wow.
This is not a good day for a couple of guys who have led this race, including Colin Bond. It looks like just purely a tyre stop.
And John Bauer, who got knocked rotten and had to make a pit stop to get that debris ripped off the rear of the car, is up running second.
Shell 1-2.
Again?
Round 5 of the Shell Ultra Australian Touring Car Championship, and the Shell team just showing once again that preparation is everything.
Well, we'll get the stopwatch on the situation here, find out where he's rejoined the race.
Now we're 42 and a half minutes into this event. Remember, duration 1 hour.
John Bauer running second now. Jim Richards is third. Trying to spot George Fury. I think he's well back after a pit stop. So Mark Skaife still in fourth spot, followed by Alan Moffat.
So Tony's had to come in for rubber.
Not only has he had to come in for rubber, he's got Dick Johnson breathing right down the back of his neck. He's almost a lap down.
That'll put a huge frown on Tony's face and a jumbo smile on Dick's. It's a bit frustrating sometimes listening to people gripe about the two Shell cars, but you have to say that it's motor racing, not Motor Expo, and the Shell team have done an unbelievable job in their preparation, and they've got two world-class drivers. They proved that at Silverstone last year in the TT, and
they're just socking it to the opposition at the moment. And you don't expect Dick or John to lay down on the job. Their job is to go flat out, drive as hard as they can, make the right decisions with their suspension, brakes and tyres, and that's exactly what they're doing. So to the knockers, I think they're going pretty good.
I don't think there's any doubt that they're doing well. The Shell series starring the Shell twins.
Yeah. There's Tim Slako in the Asanda Finance Holden Commodore debut last weekend, round four at Wanneroo. And he's doing a great job.
Trying to make some sense out of things here. Obviously, what's happening up front, Johnson leading from John Bauer. Jim Richards in third place. He's only 5.5 seconds behind John Bauer, Jim Richards, actually. Mark Skaife still holding down fourth. Then Alan Moffat, then Tony Longhurst, Neville Crichton. Chris Landon continues to head the Commodore Brigade, one lap down. George Fury out there and circulating, also best part of a lap down.
Good to see the West Aussies, Tim Slago and Alf Barbagallo, doing the final rounds of the touring car title.
Working up to a big assault for the long distance races, including the Tuohy's 1000.
And at least giving the general a presence in the Australian Touring Car Championship after the earlier plans are announced and haven't materialised as yet. However, I believe by the time Bathurst comes along, the Walkinshaw clan and whoever could be there at the mountain. In the meantime though, the West Aussies aren't doing, a bad job. I don't know who the colour coordinator was on the car.
Well, I reckon it's great, it's distinctive and it attracts a lot of interest in the paddock, and that's the go. Something a little bit different.
Three quarters of the race distance or race time has gone, 45 minutes, 15 minutes left to the checkered flag.
Georgie Fury, not the best of afternoons for George. Dropped a considerable amount of time with a pit stop at quarter distance of the race. Looks like George was involved in the melee in the first turn. The only one who didn't get involved was Mark Skaife. George is still hurling around the GTS-R turbo. And full marks go to Fred Gibson, who has pulled together a very, very strong team. When you look at young Mark Skaife having his first run of the season, he was up there battling along, running in third place for most of the race. There's a depth of talent in Australia, and it's good to see guys like Freddie Gibson giving them a run.
Now, Mike, there may have been something in the Longhurst pit stop that we didn't earlier pick up onto. I understand from some people around the circuit that the car spun. That's unconfirmed at this stage. But the pit stop may not have been a tyre wear problem. He may have literally flattered a tyre. Yeah. Not flat spot, what am I trying to say? A puncture, yeah. Speared off and has had to come in and put a set of boots on. So that's probably a pretty reasonable explanation, because there's no way Frank Gardner would underestimate with the duration or the life of his tyres for a race like this.
Well, whatever, they certainly handed second place to Johnny Bauer.
Some disagreement over George Fury's position on the track, which we're trying to clarify with the official timekeepers here at the moment. They maintain that he's running fourth, but if he in fact went to the pits, it's hard to imagine that he is. Alan Moffat on screen, running in fifth place in this fifth round of the Australian Touring Car Championship. Veteran of the field at 49. But with a list of credits you couldn't recite if you were here all day. Touring Car Championships, four times Bathurst winner, four times fourth in the 87 Spa 24-hour race, and currently in 12th position in the 89 Touring Car Championship. Wealth of experience, and another man like, I guess, the Commodore boys from the West, who's just looking ahead to that one big race on the mountain.
Yeah, and everybody says, oh, you know, Moffat's too old, Moffat's this, Moffat's that. Just cast your mind back to the Tuohy's 1000 last year and have a look at how determined the Moffat ANZ team are. He just works himself up into that one frenzy once a year. That's the grand final as far as Alan Moffat's concerned. He surrounds himself with the appropriate people. including Rudy Eggenberger, Klaus Niedzwitz. I understand he'll do that again this year. Once again, he'll be a force just as he's been ever since about 1968.
And they shouldn't start knocking 49-year-olds. Dick's well over 40. In fact, Dick's probably having his best ever season.
Talking about Fords and things overseas, Wyn Percy's driving this weekend with Andy Rouse at Donington in a one-hour touring car race over there. And so the international community are working up towards their long races, which commence in the middle of the year as well. Gee, Alan's using plenty of the rough stuff on the inside and the left-hand turn approaching the pit area. Yeah, so the interesting combinations over there. It's also interesting to note, and we mentioned at one of our earlier World Wraps this year, that Rob Gravett is doing a great job in Dick Johnson's car, which is running in England.
So the race order still, Dick Johnson, car number 17. Up front and leading from teammate John Bauer, Jimmy Richards runs in third spot. Fourth is held by Mark Skaife. Fifth by Alan Moffat. Sixth by Tony Longhurst. Seventh by Neville Crichton. Eighth is George Fury. Ninth is Chris Lambden and Gerald Kay, rounding out the 10 at this stage.
And we're 50 minutes in the race, into the race.
Mark Skaife going through, coming up to put a lap on Bob Holden. Bob must have the noisiest car here at the circuit today.
I said to him, Bob, you must be one of the very few drivers that drove in the championship last time it was held here in 1971. He said, I can't remember.
Now, when Bob says that, you know it was a while ago.
Yep.
Mark Skaife. His dad Russell is here today, and Russell was a driver of some note a few years back, and he'd be as proud as punch with the job that his young bloke's doing at the moment. He really thinks very deeply about his motorsport. He did a good job in qualifying and made up a Nissan trio, nose to tail. And wouldn't be too bad to walk away with a fourth place from an Australian Touring Car Championship at this stage of his career, and that seems as though what's going to happen.
Jim Richards has been trying to get on even terms with John Bauer, but just can't do it. Still sitting back there about 3 or 4 seconds behind him at the stage. Just ahead of Richards and Dulux Auto Colour race cam is Neville Crichton, and John Bauer one car ahead of him.
I venture to say that Jim is getting closer though, Garry.
Yes, he
just
is.
Just very
closed.
Gently.
It's closed up the gap.
It's a long time in one of these cars around a circuit like this where you never relax. There's literally nowhere on the circuit where you can flex your fingers and have a sigh and a bit of a think about it. Just work, work, work all the time. And I noticed when Peter Brock got out of his car, he looked pretty hot and bothered.
Does he look like he'd been put through the ringer? Neville Crichton going through. Neville running the second of the Benson and Hedges here. There's John Bauer, Crichton, and then Jimmy Richards. And John's found a nice little exit for that turn, straight across the top of the grass. There's the gap back from John Bauer to Jim Richards.
3 seconds it is.
Second to third.
Dick Johnson leads Bauer by 26 seconds with 3 seconds between Bauer and Richards.
Make it fairly interesting at the points table with John going into this with an 8-point advantage.
Yeah, he leads the series on 58 points. Dick Johnson on 52, Peter Brock on 30, Tony Longhurst on 28 and a half points, and Jim Richards on 28. I don't know if it'll be quite enough to turn the table.
Crichton. New Zealander who enjoys his motorsport. Very competitive car this season.
A gentleman motor racer.
Yes, he certainly is. Lovely guy.
He extensive business interests in Australia. Spends most of his time here, in fact, these days. Neville Crichton, addicted to motorsport and sailing.
Out of bottom turn.
And addicted to building his business successfully. And I know Ateco's been increasing its market share bit by bit in Australia, and Hevel's the New South Wales distributor of Suzuki vehicles, and he's been launching, relaunching Volkswagen back into Australia, and doing very well with Audi. He really, really loves his touring car racing, and a very funny guy to spend time with.
And he's doing a good job with the Skyline right behind him.
Gerald Kaye.
Gerald's car sounded like it was down to two cylinders 5 laps ago.
It's not well.
Gerald's headed down pit road. That's his day done. Jake Hart's Commodore. He does all of the touring car rounds. Strong privateur. Privateer.
And the second Sander Commodore, a little bit lifeless at the moment too.
Yes, it's coming down onto the approach to the back straight. Alf Barbagallo has already gone off down in the sand trap some laps ago.
There's Tim.
Yes, Tim Slako in the Sander Commodore from the west.
And just slipping through the shot there, Tony Longhurst and Alan Moffat going side by side down into the bottom corner. There they are. No, sorry, that's
Crichton
still.
And Bow, yeah.
That's interesting because Bow was in front of Crichton, and then all of a sudden Jim has just started to haul in John Bow like he couldn't move. Bow's in trouble. Hand out the window and waves Richards through. So Jimmy Richards now gets a lease on life and pulls up on the inside as we take our Dulux Auto Colour race cam, and now goes through the second spot. So it could all happen so quickly. They were sitting behind John's car for a number of laps, and then all of a sudden they gained on it. There you can see as we switch cameras to the Caltex race cam, the gap back to John Bowers, Jimmy Richards in the Nissan. Locks up second spot behind Dick Johnson.
Well, Bowers got a big, big gap between him and the next car, Mark Skaife, so he'll be just nursing it from here on to try and gain maximum possible points.
Tim and the officials doing the right thing and just clearing a very expensive motor car away from the edge of the track.
Tony Longhurst has got past Alan Moffat and Mark Skaife and is now up to fourth position.
Crichton and Jim Richards. Now this really brings Jim Richards' championship hopes alive. He said to me last week, what I really got to get is a win. If we can get a win, it keeps him in the fight. And he said when we get to a couple of the tighter tracks, and we've still got Winton to come, and even Sandown will suit this car.
We've been racing 57 minutes, so theoretically we've got about 2 laps remaining because Dick Johnson's just crossed the start-finish line.
Order still, Dick Johnson, the race leader now from Jim Richards, John Bow back in third spot, Tony Longhurst is fourth, Mark Skaife is fifth, Alan Moffat sixth, Neville Crichton seventh, and George Fury now up to eighth. And after looking at Gerald Kaye with all the noise and smoke and everything else pouring out of the Jake Parts Commodore, he's gone to the pits for a pit stop. Let's come back out and it sounds worse now, but he's continuing.
Well, there's the Shell prize pool goes right back down through the order, and there's dollars in all that. So he's hanging out there.
Well, he might be, but I don't think the engine is for much longer.
No, it wants to go to lunch.
Don't know how much is in the prize pool, but I don't know if it'll pay for them for a fresh engine.
It'd be an interesting equation to see whether he spends more per lap than he's likely to get.
Well, Dick Johnson, car number 17, the Shell Sierra. Watching Glenn Dix, the flagman, directly opposite. Our commentary point here at Mallala. And Dick about to come across the line. Time is running out. Of course, with a one-hour time race, no last lap board is signaled to the drivers. The only indication is when the starter who flicked on the timer when they took off from the starting line knows it's time for the end of the event. I think he's trying to calibrate that at the moment as Dick Johnson looks his way down towards the right-hander. Superb drive, superb preparation of Dick's car for this round, setting the pace in practice. He hasn't been in the best of health all week. And I dare say he'll probably be just a little second hand when he steps from the car this afternoon. It'll be pretty warm here. And I think that Dick could well be on his last lap. Yes, he is. Checkered flag should come out this time around as Johnson heads down into the S's for the final time. Coming back onto the start finishing straight, round number five. No, one more lap signals Glenn Dix. And sequels also to Dick Johnson, one lap. So that is the signal, one lap to go. It must have been pretty thorough approach from Glenn Dix. It must have been 59 minutes and 59 seconds, and he thought, no, that's not an hour race.
Does he ever do anything unprofessional?
No, he's thorough professional, our Glenn.
He's not going to die of boredom, is he? He's a live wire.
No, and he'll do his quick step and jump out here with the checkered flag shortly. Now, I was telling about Gerald Kay before. He's pulled up just short of the finishing line. I don't know whether Gerald's waiting for them to declare the race and he'll just limp across the finishing line.
I think it's slowly welding itself together.
Yes, yeah. And I tell you, I've never seen so much smoke coming. But I think all the oil's gone. It's just running on before the bearings weld themselves. However, the man moves on to the back straight now for the final time. Dick Johnson, car number 17. He hasn't won the fifth round. He's just totally demoralised the opposition here today.
Notice Mark Skaife in the dirt a bit there and losing a bit of ground.
Yep. Last corner comes up now for Dick Johnson. Sweeps out of the S's and here he comes down to take Glenn Dix's checkered flag. Johnson wins round five, the Galar at Mallala.
There's Gerald Kay smouldering across the line. Ugh. Jim Richards, Dulux Auto Colour race cam, and he's going to come home in second with George Fury right on his tail. Car number three right in behind. Jim fighting all the way to the flag. Then Neville Crichton, who's down a lap on those drivers. Great performance from Dick Johnson yet again. What can you say?
Well, there's not much more you can say.